Okay, I must say, ladies and gentlemen, greetings to you, and special to all fathers, I must say, happy Father's Day to you. And I'm not gonna say anything more, a lot about Father's Day, but my fathers, if you want to grow up your kids the right and proper way, look at this, yeah? This is it, yeah? Get the Bible and study it, yeah? Study the Bible, yeah? Oh, let me turn it right, yeah? All right, yes, study the Bible and start from Genesis 1. And you will see where a father should stand. Some of your father out there, you're wasting your time. You're wasting your days. You're wasting your substance. And later on, you're going to regret. You're going to sorry. Do the right thing. Get a woman, married, settle down, have your children. Later on, they will come and look after you. God bless you. God bless you. Me no want to base on it too much. But you know what me talk about. Do the right thing. And woman, I'm asking you. Get a man. Settle down, married, have your children. And do the right thing. God bless you. God bless you. Alright. The main thing that we're going to talk about now. Yes, the main thing that we're going to talk about now. There's some wickedness going on, and we have to talk about it. And we have to be serious in this. A man and a woman, they get married, they settle down. Yeah? The man only have one wife, and that's you. Yeah? The wickedness that we have to talk about now, and it's not good. It's not good, but we have to be plain straight. Yeah, you have your husband, and in sexual relationship, it was going fine, it was good, it was nice, it was sweet, it was this, it was that, and you name it. But you're married to a man, you're married to, and a girl, and an animal, and a lion. Sometimes a man need a little rest. Sometimes a man need a little break. In sexual relationship, me are plain straight, you know. Me are plain straight. And some of you women, because the man is not 100% active as when he just started out, you scandal the man. The man have no use. The man this, the man that. And sometimes, if you are a Christian, you carry him go to the pastor, you take him to the pastor, you take, hey, pastor, the man is not doing this, the man not sexually active and all sort of something, eh? Yes? Everybody have a problem. And this is how God make you. You know, expect the man if you go on like him a girl or him a kangaroo. He's still a human being like anybody else. Yeah, and woman, why you breaking up your relationship because you're talking about the man is not active in sexual relationship? Why you doing this to the gentleman? Why you doing this to the man? It is wrong. When you're married, you say in sickness and in health, until death do us part. You remember that word? Until death do us part. You remember it? Why you want to separate with your husband now because your husband is not sexual active? As me say again, he's still a human being. You run to him, you go to pastor, you go to advice, you WhatsApp him, you this, you that and such like, and you kill him. For what reason? He's still a human being. That's how God make him. And I look after this now. You criticize him, you gossip him. Him no good, him no this, him no that. The afterword now, him have to turn to drugs. And when him turn to drugs now, he destroying himself because he's not natural anymore. You get divorce him. You get put him away. Oh God, my God. It is wrong. It is wrong. Lady, give the man a break. Give the man a chance. You can't expect the man to run like a train every day, so. God bless you. I love you very much. I love you very much. But bear with each other. Don't put away the man because of the problem. That's how God make him. He's natural. Give God thanks. Yeah. And many of your women, you put away your husband and cause them to go out there and start to live all sort of life. For what reason? You will have to give account for these things. You're married until death do us part. And if the wife have a problem, the husband must bear with you. Bear with each other. Love each other. You say, until death do us part. God, man. And sometimes you're in a church and you can't forgive. And when you're dead, you say you're gonna heaven. What kind of heaven you're gone? You're not gonna know heaven. You can't dead with a bad heart. You can't dead and go to heaven when you can't forgive. And save Christian, whosoever you is, man and woman, wife and husband, me a talk. Forgive each other. Look after each other. Don't spread them because somewhere on the line there's a fault coming up. Love you. Respect you. More forgive a lots of joke, you know, lots of story. But sometimes we have to come to the reality. God bless you. Love each other. Yeah. Don't break up your home. Don't break up your home because
my husband is not active in bed. My husband is not this. My husband is not that.
No. Bear with him. Man, bear with your wife. If there's a problem, come up, bear with each other. Yeah? Sometimes I see some couple out there, you know, oh God, my God, me say, other day me see a couple, you know, man, and me say, I believe a wife pushed the husband in a wheelchair. You know, they live, oh God, you know what and what them passed during their life? You know what and what them passed during their life? Oh God, all sort of something them passed through, you know. But what's happened, them bear with them one another. They bear with them one another. One little something just come across. And you put away the man, you put away the woman, and talk about you going married again. How are you going with that, the second marriage? God help you. Me not grown on corner. It is wrong. Stick to your partner. Stick to your husband. Stick to your wife. Until death do us part. God bless you. Second one, I get treat you good, you know. Second one, I get treat you brilliant. You never see something like that before, you know. But to end, it's gonna be destruction. God bless you. God bless you. Someone will me talk, you know, sometimes maybe you're not gonna love everything, you know, but it's short. Some people get pretty it up and nice it up and horse out or something and whatever. But no, me not do it. Me tell you the truth. Me tell you the truth. At least you can't say you never hear the truth. God bless you. Stick to your partner. Me proud and me happy, you know. When me hear somebody say, yes, we spend 40 years together, 38 years together. 40 years together, 50 years together, 60 years together. It's not easy, you know. Lord God. If you want to hear something, sometimes they threaten one another. You watch, I'm going to kill you. I'm going to kill you. I'm going to take a pat and give you one lickisy. Then go through all that, you know. You watch me and you. They get poison you. They not do it. Yeah. I'm woolly pa threaten, you know. Woolly pa threaten. And Lord God, and then live until what? 50 years of marriage, 51 years. God have mercy, man. Sometimes they come in from what 14, from them are 14 and love one another, you know. And then go on and go on, man. A whole heap of something them pass through.
and thank God. Then see first, generation, then see second generation, then see third generation, then see fourth generation. Oh God, man, they live happy, you know, and they live good. God bless you. Join the queue. Join the queue. Nothing good in marriage and divorce. God bless you. God bless you. Stick together. Stick together. Love each other. Forgive each other. We love you.
Thank you.
Bye.